the Pacific as you know it. Wide stretches of water. But this is the Pacific as the Joint Chiefs of Staff view it. A battlefield. A vast fortress-studded plain on which key strongholds anchor a Japanese defense line guarding the heart of the homeland. The American front lines had advanced to Guam and Saipan. Ahead now stood Iwo Jima, the most heavily fortified island in the world. Buried deep underground lay 20 years of Jap preparation for murder. 20,000 of their toughest fighting men waited for us to make the first move.
And they don't have to wait long. The Navy begins to soften up the island so we can land. Carrier force take off to strafe and bomb. Gunboats move in close to work over enemy beach installations. Enemy fire gets closer. Toughest 26 days in Marine Corps history. We watch the central control vessel. When this flag drops, our landing craft will head for the beach. Landing craft in 10 waves advance on 3,000 yards of beach. Keeps us down. We want to pull the beach over our heads like a blanket. No. Corman get our wounded out fast. Our tanks come ashore and grind inland. Able to advance from Yellow Beach, but it's slow going. Into trouble on Green Beach. From their fortified positions on Mount Suribachi, the Japs look right down our throats. The command ship standing offshore. Our message is received. The situation map is checked. The support air director contacts carrier planes circling the target. The flight leader receives his instructions. From the air, supporting ships deliver point-blank fire. After 72 hours of continuous pounding, our patrols move forward. A mortar barrage searches out hidden machine gun nests. Keep a sharp lookout for snipers. Turner gives the order to cease fire. Our guns are quiet as they make the climb. We wait for a sign. Suribachi is ours.